Good afternoon, good whatever it is. It's Transformational Tuesday. Yes, my name is Judy Matejczyk. I'm a transformational life coach and creator of Paradigm Shifters. Oh, let's take a deep breath in here to August 2023. So, welcome to Paradigm Shifters. Now, we are a growing global community dedicated to shift and uplift the entire planet. And our topic for August 2023 is the spiritual life is not a theory. We have to live it. Let's take a deep breath into that quote. The spiritual life is not a theory. We have to live it. Now, let's see. I hope we're going to be talking about the power of enthusiasm, the power of enthusiasm, which is about living the spiritual life. So I hope this message finds you well and filled with that vibrant energy that only true enthusiasm can bring. So as a transformational coach, I've witnessed thousands, countless individuals experiencing incredible breakthroughs and achieving remarkable success simply by embracing the power of enthusiasm. So today I want to share with you the profound impact that enthusiasm can have on your life and urge you to take action towards cultivating it. Enthusiasm is not merely a fleeting emotion. It is a force that propels us forward, igniting our passion and fueling our pursuit of greatness. So when we approach life with genuine enthusiasm, we radiate a positivity, attract abundance, and inspire those around us. Enthusiasm empowers us to push through challenges, overcome obstacles, and embrace change with unwavering determination. So, let me ask you, when was the last time you felt truly enthusiastic about your life? When was the last time your heart pounded with excitement, anticipation, and unwavering belief in your dreams? Today, I urge you to take action and redeem your enthusiasm. So here's some different ways we're going to be doing that. Number one, embrace your passions. Reflect on what truly excites you, what stirs your soul, and what makes your heart sing. Identify those activities, causes, or hobbies that bring you immense joy and allow yourself to dive headfirst into them. Number two, surround yourself with positive influence. Seek out individuals who radiate enthusiasm and positivity. Their contagious energy will uplift you, inspire you, and help you to maintain your enthusiasm journey. Okay, I want to show you something here. See my bracelets? I want to tell you about this particular bracelet, this enthusiastic bracelet. Isn't it cool? Now, this was made by my granddaughter, Anna. And I'll tell you what, children are just enthusiastic. Well, she had this idea of mystery boxes. And I'm like, oh, okay. She's a budding entrepreneur. And I said, give me 10. I want to pass these out to my clients. And she goes, ooh, good. So she made these. It came in this envelope. I love it. Right? And I opened it up, and there were 10 of these mystery boxes inside. And I'm like, So Inside is a rubber band bracelet mystery box. It includes one bracelet and one sticker. I'm like, ooh, ooh. But it was all full of staples. I'm like, oh, I want to open up and find it out. And then on the back, she said, if your bracelet has beads, it's rare. You know, so I enthusiastically wanted to get them with the beads. So this is one that she made enthusiastically. Now, she designs this with all her different colors and different patterns. But I wear this to remind me of the enthusiasm of a child. The enthusiasm is that, sure, I can do that, you know. We're so, you know, that there's this enthusiasm. I think of Anna and centered loving energy, okay? Boom, contagious energy. The third one is practice gratitude. Cultivating enthusiasm starts with appreciating the blessings that surround us. So let's take a few moments, acknowledge and express gratitude for the wonders in your life. So this simple act will help you shift your perspective and invite more of that enthusiasm into your life. Right. So the next one is take inspired action. So enthusiasm demands action. Identify a goal or dream that excites you and take that vital first step toward its realization. Break down your aspirations into actionable tasks. And with unwavering determination, commit to making progress every day. So from a transformational life coach perspective, enthusiasm is a must because it's a powerful driving force that empowers individuals toward their goals and helps them overcome obstacles along the way. So here's a few reasons why it's so crucial. One, motivation. Yeah. So enthusiasm generates a deep sense of motivation inside of you, fueling your desire to take action and make positive changes in your life. It gives energy and determination needed to pursue your dreams and aspirations. So I have another bracelet on my wrist. This is a Rafiki. It's actually a necklace. Now, so I received this because I sponsor, you know, I contribute to the Unstoppable Foundation. And through our sponsor of Village Income training pillar, we are empowering women to lead the way for the next generation and beyond. So this is a Rafiki bracelet made with love from those women by an unstoppable mama in Kenya. I love it. So I wear generations on my wrist. I rub these all the time. So let me tell you a little bit. In Swahili, Rafiki means friend. And so I wear this Rafiki as a reminder of the role that we play in empowering entire communities in Kenya and also in all over the world. Yeah. So the second one, number two, resilience. Enthusiasm acts as a protective shield against setbacks and challenges. When faced with obstacles, enthusiastic individuals are more likely to bounce back, learn from their experiences, and keep moving forward. It helps you maintain a positive mindset and persevere through tough times. Three, attraction. Enthusiasm is contagious and attractive to others. When individuals approach life with enthusiasm, they naturally draw people towards them. This can lead to forming meaningful connections, building strong relationships, and creating a network that can further enhance personal growth. So, number four, creativity and resourcefulness. Enthusiasm sparks creativity and resourcefulness within individuals. It opens up your mind to new possibilities and solutions, allowing you to think outside the box and discover innovative approaches to challenges. I'm a former special ed teacher, and we used to like think outside the box, and my students say, "What box?" You know, because there was something enthusiastic about being with that group of individuals, these souls, that they owned who they were sometimes. And enthusiastic are more likely to find alternative paths and explore different options. So this is the beginning of school. So many of my friends, you know, this is their first day, or they're enthusiastic about that first week. And I remember a story back when I was 15 in high school, and it was the start of school, and I had worked all summer long as a waitress, saving up money because the first time I was going to be able to buy my own school clothes. No more hand-me-downs this year, and I'm like, saved all my money up, and I enthusiastically went to the, and boy, shopping was like, oh, I like that hat, or I like this, and I remember getting that outfit, first day of school outfit, because isn't that about it, the first impression, first day of school, and I remember wearing it and feeling so out of place. Because what I was wearing was not what everybody else was wearing. It had made me feel good about myself outside, but I got into an environment where, I felt, I just did not feel like I fit in. Anybody else have that? Yeah. But, I didn't have the strength or courage to be authentically me back then. But looking back at these stories, I remember the part of the story where I was enthusiastic for working so hard all summer and having the cash to go and pick out what I wanted to wear. So, that story could be spun all kinds of different ways, but in an enthusiastic mindset, that's what I wanted to take you there. Because the fifth one is emotional well-being. Enthusiasm brings joy, positivity, and a sense of fulfillment into one's life. It helps individuals experience a higher level of happiness and contentment. By cultivating enthusiasm, individuals can improve their overall emotional well-being and lead a more fulfilling life. So, what ways are you willing to cultivate your enthusiasm? Dig out some new music, could be creative in a garden. What lights your fire? What lights you up? Remember, enthusiasm is not just about being excited temporarily. It's a mindset that can be cultivated and sustained. By embracing enthusiasm, individuals can unlock their full potential and create transformative changes in their lives. This is very important. You might be the enthusiastic person, maybe the only one. Okay, what if that was your gift? What if? And remember, enthusiasm is not something that can be forced or faked. I'm going to remember that one or try it. I'm going to repeat that one. Enthusiasm cannot be something that can be forced or faked. It resonates from within. And when we align ourselves with our true passions and purpose, our spiritual life, you know, we're in alignment with our purpose and passion, which that's the spiritual life. It's not a theory. It's living into the enthusiasm, enthused with spirit, living into your purpose. So let yourself be consumed by this fire of enthusiasm and witness the change around you. Guess what? It's never too late to reignite that fire and to awaken that enthusiasm that may have been dormant for far, far too long. So I put this hat on today. I like this hat. This is my 72-year-old hat. Now, so if you're ready to embark on this exhilarating journey of personal growth and transformation, I'm going to invite you to reach out to me. And then as a transformational life coach, you know, I'm dedicated to guiding you through that process and helping you tap into your true potential. And with support on every step of the way. So with enthusiasm and unwavering support, remember, it's not something that can be forced or faked. Okay? Magical transformation awaits you. So believe in the power of enthusiasm. Believe in the power. And finally today, I want to bring you an enthusiastic person that I love, and it's a story of Yo-Yo Ma. And this is when he won the award at the Kennedy Center's honor, but I want you to pay close attention to his enthusiasm and how it transformed the world.
Good evening, Mr. President, Mrs. Obama, distinguished honorees, unregistered lobbyists. Tonight we celebrate the greatest living cellist. Tonight we celebrate, if you will. Yo-Yo Ma is a friend, a hero, and an inspiration, not just because he is a great musician, but because he is a true adventurer. And he's a fearless performer. He has done everything you can do with a cello except climb inside and ride it over Niagara Falls. But you know in your heart that if he ever did, it would totally redefine our preconceived notions of what it can sound like to plunge to your death in a cello. In fact, Yo-Yo was so accomplished, so young, that the only worry of his friends and his family was that he would peak too soon. Like so many, he would rise and then he would fall. But Yo-Yo didn't. He just rose and he rose. And then he spread out in the stratosphere. Like a mushroom cloud. I guess what I'm saying is I believe Yo-Yo Ma is seeking to weaponize his cello. Mr. President, we must impose sanctions before it is too late. Because faced with such true greatness, you have to ask, where did it come from? And of course, we all know the legend of how Yo-Yo went down to the crossroads and he met the devil there. And the devil said, "Sell me your soul and I will make you the greatest player of all time." And Yo-Yo said, "Oh, okay, thank you very much. That sounds lovely." And the devil said, "Then prepare yourself, Because I'm going to give your fingers the power to fly over those strings. When you play, men will cry and women will sigh. Because tonight, Yo-Yo Ma, I will make you the greatest blues guitarist of all time. And Yo-Yo said, well, that sounds lovely, but I play the cello. And the devil said, really, the cello? You are just going to have to practice a whole lot. I'm sorry, I cannot help you. Good luck with that. And the thing is, Yo-Yo plays with such arresting beauty that you are tempted to look for a supernatural explanation. But of course, there isn't any. There is just the completely natural explanation of the talent, the hard work, the daring, and the love that Yo-Yo gives to every moment on stage and off. So Yo-Yo, for honoring us with your art and with the example of your spirit, tonight we honor you.
Every day, I make an effort to go toward what I don't understand.
His first music was Bach. His first teacher, his father. By five, he had given his first concert. A year later, the family moved from Paris to New York. At seven, he played for a president. Yo-Yo was adored as the heir apparent to the great classical tradition. But there was something other than notes he wanted to study. He packed up his cello and headed for Harvard. Monday to Friday, he hit the books. On weekends, he hit the Brahms. Now he was ready to take his seat center stage. He turned into the wind and set off to discover the world. Then he wove the strings of his Strad into a Silk Road.
I'm not brave. I'm actually pretty scared a lot of the time. But I must like being scared because I keep doing things that scare me.
He founded the Silk Road Ensemble to follow music along its ancient routes. After all, maps have boundaries, but music has none. Thanks to all the musicians I've worked with, Yo-Yo said, I have found new meaning in my own music making. Whenever music can express gladness or sorrow, the everyday and the eternal, you will find the man the world calls Yo-Yo.
To the power of enthusiasm. Go out, live enthusiastically, dream big, dream bold, accomplish brilliantly, enthusiastically. Dude Mentecheck here. Until next week, we continue our series of Paradigm Shifters Transformation Tuesday. Thank you so very much.